Hey guys, Matt from Atlas Precision Consulting. Today's video, we're going to talk about inventory adjustments. I'm already on the screen, so let's get started. I'm going to enter in our location ID. I'm going to select our reason code. We currently only have one, but it is important to note that reason codes have GL accounts assigned to them. So you need to make sure you're picking the correct one, making sure that it's going to be hitting the GL account that is intended it to be hitting. Year and period default to your current month and year. Description is not a required field. I do recommend, if it's important to you, to use a DynaChange to make that a required field. Just helps you out if you're trying to do research in the future. So we're going to come down here and we're going to put in our item that we're going to adjust. You'll see there's two different quantities here. We have quantity on hand and quantity allocated. The reason that's important is you can't adjust below quantity allocated. If I come in here and try to say I want to take out negative 200, it's going to tell me I can't do that. I'm going below my quantity allocated, which means I need to go out and unallocate some inventory to make that adjustment happen. So I'm going to zero that back out. Something else, there's two different ways you can enter your count. If you know you're adjusting out 100 of these, you can put a negative 100 in here, and it's going to put your new quantity on hand. Or if you just went and counted and said, oh, I have 7,185, it will do the inverse and do the adjustment math for you. Now, since this is a lot and we do track bins in this system, we do have to go to the lot bin tab to enter in which lot that we are going to be removing those items from. If you're not doing a lot bin, it's not important. And then you do have to put in your quantity. Now, it's interesting to note, even though I'm doing a negative adjustment on this tab, it is a positive number, which is a little different than some of the other screens. And at that point, we just hit save and it will post it. One other thing I want to call out to that was very useful in to me in a previous life. If you use decimal places, there's an option to choose how many decimals you display. The issue is the P21 database still goes up to 9 decimals regardless what you're displaying. So if you're trying to adjust something that you keep in decimal quantities and it keeps giving you an error saying, hey, you're not adjusting out enough, or you don't have that much to adjust out, click this show all decimal places and it'll show you. So you may see 100.01 on your screen, but when you click that, you may see 0.0002 that rounds up to your two decimal place, which would be 0.01. So just something to keep in mind if you are using decimal places. If you don't use decimal quantities, not really a problem for you, and you just hit save and it's posted. If you guys have any questions about this, or you want to see some videos on some different stuff, put a comment below. Make sure you like and subscribe. We're trying to do a lot of these videos for you guys. And always, Atlas is here for your P21 needs.